Hello everyone, Danaa Sahir with ActionVFX. In this tutorial, we are going to learn how to create a seamless loop on any stock footage element. As you can see from these elements that have been looping several times since this video started. We have made a previous tutorial on creating a simple footage loop, so in this one, we're gonna expand upon that and try many different ways you can loop a VFX footage. We are going to be using stock footage from ActionVFX. You can check out all the products collection that I'm using on the description below. Anyway, without further ado, let's get started. Now, as you already know, the key to get a perfect seamless loop is for your video to have the start and end frames that connect to each other. Like here, the end frame of the bullet shell directly continues to the first frame. So once you have that loopable footage, we want to loop it in a composition, and there are many ways to do it. First way is to just manually duplicate the layer multiple times, and then you want to arrange them sequentially. And your footage is going to loop. Of course, this method is tiring and messy, so let's find another way. If the layer that you want to loop is a freshly imported footage and not a precom, you can just go to the layer here on the project bin and right click, interpret footage, main, and at the bottom here, you can type in the amount of loops that you want. Let's say 3 loops. And there we go, our layer duration has been tripled. And when we pull the end tail here, we can see that our footage is now looping. Now, if you don't have any fixed number on how many times you want to loop, or if the layer that you want to loop is a precomp, you can just use an expression. Right click on our layer here, and time, enable time remapping. And then you want to alt click on the stopwatch, and type loop, and because we want to extend it to the right, let's pick loop out. So now we can extend the tail end of the footage and loop it indefinitely. Now, let's start to do the same with other elements. Many of our collections actually provided elements that are quite long in duration, like this rain here that is 20 seconds long. So if your shot isn't longer than that, you don't need to loop our stock asset. But let's say you want to have an uncut 1 hour shot using our elements. So here I have this precomp of our rain element. Inside the precomp is just the original super long rain footage that I have trimmed into just 6 seconds here, just so it's not overwhelming to work with for this tutorial. Okay, so now let's try loop our rain precomp here to see what it looks like. And there we go. You can see that we have a slight jump between the loop cycle. This is because the first and last frames of the rain layer here do not directly continue or connect with each other. They are similar, but not enough. So what we're going to do is to connect the first and last frames of this layer to create a seamless loop. Okay, so we have our 6 second rain here on a new composition. You can do this process directly with the raw import file of the footage instead of in a precom like I'm doing here. First, we're going to split the layer into two. And I like to do it in the middle. And we're going to Control Shift D to split the layer. And then let's add a marker to mark where we split the layers so we don't get confused. And then we want to move the layers so the middle split is now on each end of the durations. So now if we hit play, we can see that what we're doing is to make the end and the beginning to connect and just move the meeting of the layer first and last frame to the middle. So what we're going to do next is to smooth out the meeting of these two. So what we're going to do is we're just going to move the second layer here so there is some overlap. And then what I like to do as well is to have the second part of the layer to be on top. And here, because our rain does not have a transparent background, it has a black background, the layer on top automatically covers the layer at the bottom. Now, we can see as well that our composition is getting shorter, but that is fine because in order to create a loop, we have to do a little bit of one step backwards and two steps forwards kind of thing, where you will lose some of the initial duration, but the result later will be a footage that you can loop forever. So let's adjust our timeline work area here. And then what we want to do is we want to create a cross dissolve or fade in fade out between these two layers. So they will have a smoother transition. So let's press T to bring out the opacity. And then let's solo our top layer here. And we want to go to the beginning of the overlap and turn it to 0. And then add a keyframe and then move to the end of the overlap and increase it to 100. So now our rain on top is fading in. So let's disable the solo And since our layer here is not transparent, I do need to animate a fading out on the layer at the bottom here. And now if we hit play, we can see that we have a smoother transition, but it's still not smooth enough. The transition is way too fast, so we're going to make it smoother. And to do that, we're just going to increase the overlap and then extend our animation to fit that increase. And of course, we are losing more duration, but again, that is something that we have to do. So now if we hit play, we have a much more seamless transition and we're getting the perfect loop. So now what we're going to do is we're just going to composition and trim comp to work area to finalize the duration of our pre-composition here. And then what you can do is you can just render this, or you can go to the main composition where you want to do your VFX and bring our rain loop pre-comp that we just made and start looping it. And there we go, a seamless looping rain. So this method works because the rain element is moving really fast and it has a consistent movement and animation across the duration of the elements. So for example, if we go back to our loop and then go inside our rain trimmed pre-comp, and then we want to replace our original rain footage with another rain footage, you would still have a seamless result. And not only that, this method also seemed to work with snow element as well. So now let's do something that is a little bit more tricky. So I have this energy ball here from our energy balls collection going in and out, but I want to loop just the middle part where the energy ball is fizzling. Okay, so just like before, I have the energy ball trimmed and pre-comp only the fizzling part where I want to loop. So now we want to do the same thing again. We want to split and then move each end of the splits. And then we want to create an overlap, which of course we are losing a lot of duration, but that is fine. Okay, so now we are having something a little bit different than the rain. When we look at the overlap, we see an increase of brightness on our energy ball. That is because our energy ball doesn't have a black background, so it is see-through to the layer at the bottom. So in order to dissolve this, what we want to do is we want to fade in the top and then at the same time fade out the bottom. So now this is what we have. Now, it's almost perfect, except that we have this weird shift on our brightness. That is because of the change of opacity on the layers. So, let's bring back those brightness that we lose. We can do this by offsetting the overlapped a little bit, which of course at the risk of losing more duration. If that doesn't work, what we can do is to add a black background to the energy ball, just like what we had with the rain. And to do that, we're just going to go to effects and type in solid composite. Change it to black, and then copy and paste it to the second one. And then just like the rain, we want to disable the fade out animation of the layer at the bottom. So now let's finalize the duration again. And now we have our seamless looping energy ball, but at the cost of losing the transparent background. So to bring back the transparent background, we're just going to pre-comp these two layers. And then let's get After Effects on mode preset. And we're going to change the shift channel to blue. And there we go, we have bring back our transparency. Now let's move on to looping smoke assets. So here I have this small scale smoke plume billowing to the right. And here we can see that we have a very massive overlap. That is because this smoke moves slower compared to the rain and the energy ball. So it needs slower transition to match its speed. And as you can see, we already have the black solid background here, so our smoke is not transparent. That means we can try doing our normal dissolve, and this is what we have. It's already looking really good, except there's still some part here that looks a little bit too obvious. So we're going to make this even more seamless. And to do that, we're going to create a directional transition. So let's disable our opacity here. So what I meant by that is that I want the transition to fade in gradually and mimics the movement of the actual smoke. So I wanted to fade in from this part first and moves along to this part instead of just dissolving entirely at the same time. So to do that, we're going to create a solid and then let's disable our layer here. And then what I want to do is create a mask that mimic the shape and movement of the billowing smoke. So we're going to bring our mask path and we want to animate this to move along with the smoke. Okay, so this is what we have. You can see the mask is moving across the layer at the same speed of the smoke. So now we were going to turn this on and then we're going to feather it really big. And then I want to make the shape of the mask to be a bit more chaotic to follow the fluidity of the smoke. So let's get turbulent displace. And we want to just play around with the shape a little bit. And then let's alpha matte the top layer of the smoke to the matte. If we solo the layer, we can see what we're doing to the second layer of the smoke here. And if we play the entire thing, this is what we have, a more seamless loop. Before we go further, if you are enjoying this video, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and like this video because your support means a lot to us. And now let's go back to the video. Okay, so now let's apply all the things that we have learned from all the previous composition to loop a fire. And for demonstration, I'm going to use this ground fire from Ground Fire Volume 2 collection. First, of course, just like the energy ball, you don't want to loop the entire duration. You just want to pick a range where the fire is most consistent. After a bunch of trial and error, I found that this range here around this area is the most perfect to loop. So I have isolated around 5 seconds of that range on this composition. And if we hit play, you can see the disconnect between the first and last frame, but it is not super significant. Because while the fire shape at the beginning and at the end of the sequence does not connect, they still have a pretty consistent size and velocity. So now let's smooth out the transition of these two frames. So first I want to pre-comp this, move all attributes, and then let's split the layer and move them so the first and last frame meets in the middle. And this is what we have. So now let's loop this. So let's create our overlap for the transition. For this, I found around almost 1 second overlap between the two layers to work best. Okay, so now, as you noticed, the fire doesn't have a black background. It is transparent like the energy ball that we have earlier. So now let's try our first transition attempt, which is doing the fade in and fade out. So we want the top layer to fade in into the scene and the second one to fade out. And this is what we have. So it is getting there. And actually, if you add some glow effects or maybe this fire is far away, this may not be noticeable, but we want to make something better than this. We want to make the fire loop more seamless. So to do that, we're going to approach it just like looping the smoke, which is creating a gradual transition. So first, let's delete the animation on the opacity and start over. And then let's create a solid and add linear wipe effects. So linear wipe is just a simple linear transition. And then I'm going to change the wipe angle to 5 degrees. So it's horizontal, but not a straight horizontal. And then let's animate the transition completion from 0 at the beginning of the overlap and 100 at the end. Okay, so now let's increase the feather of the transition. And then I want to add a solid composite and change it to black so we have a clear black and white matte. So we will use Aluma matte instead of Alpha matte later. So now let's pre-compose our transition matte here. Move all attributes and OK. So now inside of the pre-comp, let's add some texture to our transition. So let's create another solid. Let's name this fractal. And then I want to add fractal noise. Then let's change the fractal type to dynamic progressive and then invert it and then go to the transform and uncheck the uniform scaling. And let's reduce the scale width to something like 60. So now our fractal noise is squished and we have this plasma looking look. Now let's put our fractal layer to the bottom of the transition mat and change the mode to hard light. And there we go. Now we have our fractal noise only affecting the gray area of the transition, creating this cool looking transition effects. And next, let's get an adjustment layer and let's get curve. And I want to essentially pull the black and white color to create a contrast. And then let's make our transition a little bit more chaotic. So let's get turbulent displace. And then we want to play around with the amount and size a little bit until we get this cool looking flaming look. And then we want to animate this a little bit by alt click on the evolution and add expression time times 500. Okay, so now we have this cool looking flaming transition. So now let's go back to our fire loop precomp. And first, I want to change the color of our transition mat here, just so we can distinct our layers. So now we want the fire on top to use this matte precomp to gradually appear. So that means we want to matte it to the black color. So on the track mat, let's select Luma Inverted. Now if we solo our fire, this is what we have. And then let's duplicate our transition mat and move it down. And then I want to Luma matte the bottom one to the fire. So we're mapping it to the white area of the mat. And if we solo this, this is what we have. So now let's hit play and see our loop. Okay, so it's almost perfect, except on our transition here, we have this weird dark line happening. So to fix that, what we can do is to just offset one of the transition mat. So to give you a clearer look, let's solo this fire here. And what I want to do is to just offset this, let's say for one frame. There we go. So now the dark areas is covered. So this is before and this is after. So now if we hit play, our scene is practically perfect. Now, of course, if you really go this slow frame by frame, you can see a little bit of movement of that seam here. But when you play it, it's barely noticeable. And when you add glow effects into the fire, it practically disappears. So now let's finalize the duration of our comp here. Composition, trim comp to work area. And let's bring our fire to a longer composition. So we have our comp here. Let's bring our fire loop that we just made. And then let's make this loop forever. So right click, time, enable time remapping, alt click, and let's type loop out. And let's pull this, and we have our looping fire. So this looping workflow that we just made actually works with some other fire elements as well, such as this fire trunk from ActionVFX Forest Fire Collection, and this torch from Flame Torch Collection. So if you want to make a 1 hour continuous shot of a forest fire, or a torch burning, you can. Now, sometimes you have this issue where when you do the time remap loop, it adds this extra black frame at the end. We can fix that by going to the end of the keyframe of the remap here, move backwards one frame, add another keyframe, and delete the old one. And there you go. And that was how to create a seamless loop for your stock footage. Once again, if you want to purchase all the elements that I used in this tutorial, you can check out our website at actionvfx.com. At ActionVFX, we provide vast library of high-quality VFX stock footage for your projects. From fire and smoke, energy effects and explosions, and many, many others. You can purchase them directly or sign up to our subscription starting at the low cost of $14.99 a month. This is the most affordable way to access our library, it's saving you at least 80% off, including our subscribers-only free collections, and you can cancel anytime, no contract. Thank you so much for watching. I encourage you to drop a like and let us know in the comment section below what kind of tutorials that you'd like to see next. But most of all, be sure to subscribe. We are aiming for 100,000 subscribers by the end of the year. And also, there are other resources on this channel, such as other VFX tutorials, podcasts, VFX breakdowns, and many others. So be sure to check them out as well. Let us be your number one resource for visual effects. So, see you next time. Bye-bye.